25 years old. I'm in real life, in normal circumstances, I'm just trying to get established as a biology researcher in Cairo University. But right now I have another role I'm playing, which is a social media activist. I'm Mona Sosh on Twitter, M-O-N-A-S-O-S-H. I'm Mona Sosh everywhere, really. I would agree that Facebook and social media in general were definitely used as a tool, particularly important in the phase of preparation leading to January 25th, whether preparation between different groups and different governance, announcing the locations, organizing the different support groups like the legal aid group, emergency, and so on. And it played a role after January 25th, between January 25th and January 28th, on sending out information about what's happening, so mobilizing more people to join. But after that, the role of social media in the revolution was really peripheral. It was mainly as a means of leaking info out to the public, to the audience, to people watching what was happening. But it in no way played a role in mobilizing people. And it suddenly, and at this point, it became really a people's movement, and it was beyond any technology means control or influence. Yes, the beginning of it, a lot of it was the work of the young generation. So I think it is sort of our right or their right to always give them credit for that. But after a while, it really wasn't. It was a people's movement, and what we managed to achieve, we couldn't have achieved it without the 30 years of struggle of older generations, of their small and small and small attempts to push and work, of their breaking gradually the barrier of fear and hitting the streets and protesting and so on. The situation is we are waiting for parliamentary elections in September, so this is the main buzz, and this is what everyone is working on, mainly forming parties, discussing elections. On the other hand, the situation is that the army is sort of in power now, and they are exploiting the power, in my opinion. I was witness to one in particular who was beaten up by the army, and then he was falsely accused of attacking an officer, and he got sentenced 5 years. So now it's another battle that we have to do, because at the end of the day, the army are a big institution, and a lot of those in power in the army were part of the old regime. So they benefit from the old regime and the old system, our struggle continues against them. But it's not as bad as before, because people understand the power they have. They just need to get the info. So our main battle is to get the info out, because our media again are not willing to approach the issue of army violation at all. People need to be aware of what's happening, to maintain the pressure on the army so the army stops their violations and reassess what they have done. The more you bring to them cases of protesters or young people who are just out in the street or passing by, and they got dragged into all of this and they got tortured and they got labeled thugs, it makes it more easy for people to see the human rights issue behind the problem of military trials. Violations. Yes, I'm hating that I'm away, partially because the news is not covering it, and you know that you would be helping to send out more info for others, but also I just think at this point it really counts every person who is willing to be out there despite what's happening. Juggling between both, I completely devoted myself to revolution till Mubarak stepped down, and then when we forced Mubarak to step down, I would go and sleep in Tahrir, and then wake up in the morning, go on the lab, finish work, and then go home, change, and go to Tahrir. A big part of why I'm doing all of this is actually my work. I want to be completely devoted to scientific research, and with the old system there was no funding for it, there was no place for it, and for a lot of people it was a constant struggle, or you have to go out, get established, and then come back and fight, you know, but while you're established. And right before the revolution, I'm finishing my master's, and I was gonna go for New York for the PhD, and or other places. And then the revolution changed this, because suddenly it made it possible that I have a place here and that I should work here. And I've seen this with many other young people I know who are abroad, either working or studying, and they all are wrapping up to come and return here and start working here. So whatever we are doing, for us, this is why we are doing it, because we want to establish a place here where we can do what we love to do and do it well, and, you know, help in building this new Egypt that we experience. Realize that really the power is in the people, and that all sorts of talk about people are not ready, people will not understand, is not true at all. Once people get the information, and once it has to do with their life, their country, their basic needs, they move about it. Also, how this all new technology is just really good when it is, addressed as a tool to expand your network and to reach out for different groups and coordinate together. So that's all I would say. Okay.